So recently, 39 perks got reworked in Dead by Daylight, and Killer got a bunch of base kit buffs. Dead Hard got nerfed, Decisive Strike got nerfed. The speed boost that you get when taking an endurance hit has been reduced. And I've been noticing that a lot of people have been saying that solo queue has become unplayable in Dead by Daylight. Lots of you guys may know of the infamous Dead Hard, Spine Chill, Bard Time, Decisive Strike build that almost 50% of the community used. And now all those perks are changed. How do we get away from killers anymore? It feels like to some people that I've lost every single perk that I've used for the past 6 years. But I argue that some of the perks that Behavior reworked act almost exactly like how some of the old meta perks used to run. For instance, when it comes to Barred Time, if you run off the record, you get to give yourself Barred Time for 80 seconds. You can even use the new reworked Barred Time and have 15 seconds of endurance. And if the killer decides to tunnel you, you have 15 seconds of the 7% extra haste speed effect. It's almost as if Barred Time got like a mini buff. And a lot of time you would use Barred Time to help save your teammates from getting tunneled. So that's where I point the finger at We're Going to Live Forever. If the killer decides to slug a survivor, you effectively can give your teammates Soul Guard for 10 seconds by picking them up off the ground. That's like a Barred Time. There are a lot of great alternatives for Barred Time as an anti-tunneling perk if you don't want your teammates getting tunneled off hook. And even if you're getting tunneled, you can use off the record. That's insane. When it comes to Dead Hard, it's extremely hard to use now. The timing is down to 0.5 seconds in order to tank a hit, and the speed boost that you gain is a lot less than normal. You may hear people saying just use Lithe, Overcome, or Balanced Landing, but that's not necessarily the same. It's hard to time it during a chase. Sometimes the killer just gets me. And that's where I argue you could use Sprint Burst. Because if you 99 your exhaustion on Sprint Burst, you can get a speed boost during a chase. Get a burst of speed while the killer's chasing you, almost like old Dead Hard, like Dead Hard for distance. You can do this to even avoid a hit. This Sprint Burst is almost like old Dead Hard, just a little bit harder to use. When it comes to Spine Chill, you may have trouble knowing when the killer is coming to you. A lot of people like to use this perk on a generator so they know when to leave a generator. I argue you could use a perk like Any Means Necessary, which tells you which pallets are being dropped and effectively which teammates are getting chased and where they are on an unlimited range. Kind of like Spine Chill, tells you where someone's getting chased, it tells you where the killer is. With Dark Sense, every single time someone pops a generator, Dark Sense activates. And as soon as the killer comes within 24 meters of you, you get to see the killer's aura. This may proc while you're working on a generator, and it works like Spine Chill. It shows you exactly where the killer is coming from. Let's say you're getting chased. It shows you through the walls what the killer is doing through the walls. Just like Spine Chill. Even better than Spine Chill as a nice killer detection perk. If you use Spine Chill more for evading the killer, you can even use a perk like Guardian, which when you unhook a survivor, you get to see the killer's aura for 8 seconds, along with giving the teammate you're unhooking suppressed scratch marks and pools of blood, along with a 7% haste effect. And some people use Spine Chill to get away from the killer, to hide. You can use a perk like Lucky Break in order to suppress your scratch marks and blood pools for 60 seconds. And every single time you start healing somebody, you actually refill your Lucky Break stacks in order to like lose a killer. If you use Spine Chill for its old vaulting speed, you can actually just use Resilience for a 9% vault speed buff when you're injured. Although it may not be the same Spine Chill, you can choose one of these perks to give you a similar effect where you need it the most. A lot of people are also complaining that Iron Will got nerfed. There is no feasible way to be completely silent away from the killer. If you use off the record, when you get unhooked, you get Barred Time for 80 seconds, and you also make zero grunts of pain, like old Iron Will. Off the record is like a combination of Barred Time and Iron Will in one perk. It may be tied to just 80 seconds when you get unhooked, but it's still Iron Will. A lot of people have also been complaining that Decisive Strike is dead since it got cut down from 5 seconds to 3 seconds. And I argue that the only thing that is bad about Decisive Strike is that it's just a little bit harder to use. You don't get 5 seconds to get to safety, you get 3. So what can I do to get to safety? I can go down close to a window or a pallet. If I'm close to a window or a pallet, it doesn't matter if I have 3 seconds or 5. I'm immediately going to safety. It's just that I need to think about where I'm going when I have Decisive Strike active, in order so I could get maximum potential out of my perk. Decisive Strike requires you to think about where you're going rather than just mindlessly stabbing the killer and getting a free escape no matter where you are. Decisive Strike is still really good. I want to point to the fact of Circle of Healing. When Circle of Healing was nerfed, what a lot of survivors did is that they just started running medkits. You nerfed my boon healing ability, I'm just going to bring medkits to heal myself. They found a replacement to a perk that they loved. And I feel like all 39 perk reworks are extremely underappreciated because there are so many replacements to the old meta perks that survivors once had. And a lot of you guys may tell me that the perks may just suck. I'm looking for a build. I'm looking for something that works together to make sure that I don't get killed. Okay, so I decide to use a bunch of builds on the live servers to try to outplay the killers and see how hard of a time that I had on playing against them. Unlucky. It has a cooldown, doesn't it? Unlucky. Okay. Okay. Woo! Ah, Saboteur. Wow, that's really good. Oh, nice try, nice try, nice try. This way is better. Into this. But this is a no way out way. Dwight! Give me energy! I tried. Each time a generator is completed, Dark Sense activates. In a way, like a replacement spine chill, best as possible. But like, we don't want people using toolboxes more efficiently, right? Nope, it's not gonna work here. This might work to get a hit. That regardless. I'm not willing to use Shag Pallet here. Come on. The right. Oh, this Michaela. Look at that. Sprint burst into Sabo. You don't make that. Wow. Lucky break. And he lost us. Okay. He'll lose us because we don't have scratch marks. I try. Let me write something down. There is a lot of viable builds in Dead by Daylight. I just feel like a lot of the survivor community is extremely resistant to change. I'm a killer main. I love playing survivor. I found a fuckload of builds. These builds are really good in solo queue and they work. Some of these perks are insane. Some of the synergies that you can have with different builds is crazy. It's been so much fun for me to actually mess around with different builds. This update is insane. There is so many different things you can do. The synergies are limitless. I don't think solo queue is impossible. I just think that there's a meta waiting to be discovered with all the crazy new effects that Dead by Daylight now has to offer. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. You'll have a good one.